I'm TV6 meteorologist Eric DeBroca, and here's a look at your latest weather on demand forecast. Well, we saw another day and another rain storm across the UP, especially the southern half, and we're really racking up the totals, especially in that area. I'll show you that in just a minute. But you can see it on the 6-hour radar loop here, really some impressive totals, especially in the southeastern portion of the UP, Escanaba and Manistique. But right now, we are starting to get some drier air in, and really made for a nice sunset across much of north and western portion of upper Michigan there. And that will do a little bit to our temperatures tonight. That will help to drop them in that area. And the rest of the UP, though, is going to hang on to upper 50s, to right even near 60 in the southeast. But here are those rains I was talking about. Now, this is not what we saw on Saturday and Sunday. This would be what we saw on the combination of both of those days there. And so we racked up 3/4 inches of rain for Escanaba and Manistique, roughly. Iron Mountain, 8/400. And I bring this to your attention because look at this next one here. I find this pretty interesting. National Weather Service in Marquette, 0.05 inch of rain from both of those days of rain. And Marquette was just really the only city that was dodging raindrops here. By the way, in Keweenaw County and Copper Harbor, they saw their fair share of rain on Thursday with the severe storms. They just didn't see any of that severe stuff like the rest of us did. No hail, damaging winds there. They just saw heavy rains. But still, really, it was just northern Marquette County dodging Thursday and also the second half of the weekend. Highs today, though, were pretty similar all across the region. We saw 70s all the way draped from west to east. 71 seems to be a common theme as well from Houghton, Escanaba to Manistique. 67, though, from Munising, as we did have a little bit of a lake breeze, especially early on Sunday. As far as temperatures off to the west, it was 102 in Pierre just about an hour ago here on Sunday evening, but now we've since cooled off there to 97. As far as the rest of the region goes, really there's a rather strong ridge of high pressure centered over the northwestern portion of the country and across our neck of the woods and all the way across the east as well. There's a trough. And that's going to hang with us really through this entire week. 77 down in Madison, low 80s in Minneapolis. And here's another one of cold front that swiped through. And it's going to turn into a stationary front and hold steady right across just north of Milwaukee there. So continued rain showers for areas downstate, areas for Green Bay, Madison. They're under the gun for just some more showers for the day tomorrow. Whereas we're going to start to clear out at least a little bit. So if you're far enough south, namely Menominee County, and even in down into Escanaba, you could see some showers tomorrow as well. But look at this box here. We see the red. That signifies a tornado watch is in effect through this evening for southern Minnesota and just south of the Twin Cities there. So the air is not that unstable, rather not that far away from us. Here's our weather picture, though, for Monday. We see rain showers dodging Marquette area once again, so no surprise there. But notice, though, as we get into the second half of the day, high pressure will slide into our region, or at least close by, into Minnesota. That will allow mainly sunny skies, or at least partly sunny skies, especially for the north. Then on Tuesday, our weather picture looks like this. We'll see that high pressure slide down to our south, in between Milwaukee and Chicago. And for us, we're going to start the day with brilliant sunshine. And then the second half of the day will feature a return to mostly cloudy skies, and by evening, mainly cloudy skies with some light showers off in the west here. And that's going to be our weather for Wednesday. But overnight tonight, we will see temps dip down to the 50s, coolest low in the Keweenaw Peninsula, 51 to 58. The winds turn around tomorrow from the north. Therefore, it will be coolest in that direction, right around 70 across Marquette and Munising. Heading inland, though, Gwynn, Sawyer, mid-70s there, down to the Southwest UP, we're in the upper 70s. Now your TV 6-day forecast. We see really 70s extend through Tuesday. Wednesday, though, we do have that front come through, and that's going to knock temperatures back. 70 will be the ballpark figure, but it will be cooler to the north and west as colder air starts to filter on in from Canada. And look at Thursday's highs back in the 60s, kind of similar to last Friday, how that was. Morning showers, giving way to afternoon sunshine. But then next week, we start to tap into some real warm weather.